Hello, and today we are with Mr. Jani Jolkkonen, who is the Senior Vice President Airport Network at Finavia. Good afternoon to you, Jani.
Good afternoon.
Now, you locally are called Mr. Lapland because I believe you are in charge of the Lapland Airport.
I'm actually responsible for all the regional airports of Finavia. So basically, we are operating 20 airports in Finland. I'm responsible for 19 of them.
That's quite some portfolio you have there. In terms of the airports that are under your control, how has the post-COVID recovery, where are we at the moment with that?
All in all, at Finavia, the recovery rate at the moment is something like 70%. But we are seeing especially strong growth at the moment at our Lapland airports. And there we are actually have recovered already the pandemic that we saw during the recent years. So we are all over those passenger volumes already.
That's in 2023?
Yeah.
What do you put that success down to? What is the reason for Lapland's success in terms of...
Lapland really has been a success story after this COVID that we have been seeing. Basically, we don't have the Asian traffic anymore so much at the moment, but that has been compensated by the European travelers. And maybe that's because of the nature that we are having in Lapland. We are having lots of free space, clean air, very well functioning processes, that kind of things. And the people tend to appreciate that kind of things after COVID.
You mentioned you've lost some of the Asian traffic, which hopefully you'll get back. Who has replaced that Asian traffic?
It's mostly European traffic that has been replacing that. And hopefully, of course, we hope that we will one day soon already see the Asian traffic coming back. And of course, then the growth is once again a bit more.
Which markets in particular are you looking at for Asian markets?
For Asian markets.
For the Asian markets, which specific markets within Asia are you looking at?
Of course, at the moment, the Asian market is only a very small part of the traffic that we used to have before the COVID. But of course, Chinese, Japanese, that kind of markets are interesting for us.
And could you explain, because a lot of people don't really know what Lapland is all about. A lot of people think it's just a Christmas, just a winter destination.
Yeah.
What is there to do in Lapland? Why should people go there?
Yeah, of course, at the moment, it's very much about winter season in Lapland. Basically, people come there to have ski activities, winter sports, and that kind of activities. Also, see the Santa Claus, especially the Rovaniemi Airport, that's the home base of Santa Claus from our perspective, and that kind of things, and also clean air, snow, all that whiteness, quietness, those kind of things.
In terms of numbers, what sort of numbers are we talking about? You say that you've passed pre-COVID levels. What sort of numbers are we looking at in terms of passengers?
We've invested before the COVID to our Lapland airports, and we are targeting for 2 million passengers on a yearly basis in the long run. At the moment, we are something around 1.5 million euros. So say 1.5 million passengers. So basically, we are having room for improvement still, but we are strong in growth at the moment.
Now, of course, people, when they do think of Lapland, they think of sustainability. Yeah. But it's not just Lapland. Yeah. When they think of the Swedish countries and Finland, yeah, they do think of sustainability.
Yeah.
What sustainable initiatives are in place at those airports in Lapland?
Yeah, sustainability is a very important topic for us also. We have been actually carbon neutral since 2019 at all our airports. And our next target is going to be net zero in 2025. So we are very much investing on that also.
How are you going to go from being carbon neutral to net zero in that time frame that you mentioned? What are you going to put in place to do that?
We are all the time cutting off the emissions that we are having in our operations. At the same time, we are compensating the emissions that we are still having in our operations. And we are continuing on that. We have basically cut half of the emissions that we used to have 10 years ago with our own activities.
Now, of course, Rolls-Royce next month will be testing with Virgin Atlantic a 100% SAF flight across the Atlantic. But of course, sustainable aviation fuel brings with it problems for airports. They have to have the systems in place to handle it.
Yeah, for sure.
What is the situation in Lapland and the other airports that Finavia looks after?
We also are investing in that, of course. Airlines are taking care of the fuel and that kind of things. But we are investing that we have to support the airlines in those initiatives.
In terms of one of the challenges in terms of recruitment for airports as well across the industry, a lot of people are talking about recruitment being a challenge. What challenges are you facing in terms of finding the right people to manage and run the airports that you have?
That's of course a challenge for us also, because the winter season in Lapland is very strong, and we are still seeing less demand during the summer season. So that's why we have to get more personnel during the winter time. And that's, I would say, a project every year that we are getting people in kind of to take care of the business during the winter time. But at the same time, of course, we are trying to build up the summer seasons.
More and more airports are using official electric taxis. What is the situation in terms of Finavia with regards to the official taxi companies that you work for in terms of the sustainable side, that sustainable side of the business?
We are having those also to some extent in our airports, but not in a huge share of, not so much.
In terms of technology, because of course technology is an important thing to make the airport processes work behind the scenes, but also for the passenger experience. What new technology do you foresee the airports that you look after embracing in the future?
Of course, there are all the time new kind of development and new kind of technologies. For instance, self-service in the process that we are seeing our terminals. Of course, we are all the time trying to automate our processes in the maintenance work. Those are the main areas, I would say.
Are there any particular, like fast track? You mentioned the self-service kiosks. There's also, of course, beacon technology, yeah, and what have you. Is there any in particular that you're actually spending the most money? Where's the most investment going in terms of enhancement?
Not so big improvements in the Lapland airports at the moment, but basically self-service in the terminals, yeah.
Excellent. Well, I have to say, Jani, thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, I wish you and everybody at Finavia the very best of luck for the future. Thank you.
Thank you.